Amazing.
The lag that makes it so
we
much
tried.
Harder.
We tried.
We were dead. Jen, I couldn't hear you.
Yeah, I was.
I couldn't hear it. I feel really bad.
We tried to have a really like entertaining intro. Hope you guys enjoyed it. But welcome to our.
Oh, did we start our?
Yes.
We're live.
We're live.
I thought we were practicing. I'm sorry. That we're practicing.
We really did try. Okay, but hope you guys enjoyed that. So anyway, today, guys, we're going to be talking all about Chinese music. If you didn't already know. I'm very excited for this topic. We have so many lovely musicians who are interested in the Chinese music community. So I think the first thing that we ought to do is to introduce everybody and say, who are we? Where are we? Why are we interested in China, Chinese music, that whole thing? So why don't we, let's start with JJ.
Yay!
Okay. Hi, everybody. I am JJ, and I am based in New York City. I'm originally from New York City. If you've seen some of my videos, you might know that. I'm primarily interested in Chinese language, and then sort of like as a result of that, I'm also interested in Chinese music. Because I grew up, you know, my mom does the whole Broadway thing. So it's just kind of like taking the two things I love, combining the two things I love, music and Chinese, and putting them together. So I think it's a natural conclusion. You know what I mean?
Totally.
Yeah.
I love like your little background and how, and I totally agree with you. I think you're interested in
my e-girl background.
Love it. Love it.
Thank you. Yeah.
Okay. Well, love that. So how about Laurier? Let's go with you next.
Hey, what's up? I'm Laurier. I'm based in Ottawa, Canada. I got into Chinese music. I got found on YouTube by an agent who gave me the opportunity to go work on cruise ships in Asia, specifically performing for Chinese people. He directed me to the right website to start learning Chinese. YoYoChinese.com. Still love them. And
right after you, I love YoYo Chinese as well.
You know YoYo Chinese as well?
Yeah, they're so good.
So great to start tones and learning to read pinyin was so important. And then I started learning Chinese songs that I knew were popular and started getting requests and learning what people want to hear and performing for Chinese people, learning more and more words, taking notes on my phone, and then expanding my vocabulary. And now I can string sentences together, and I plan on becoming full fluent one day.
Yes. A worthy goal, a noble goal.
I think it's possible.
It is. No, 100%. No, that wasn't like sarcastic. It's definitely possible.
Yeah. No, I know.
No, it's definitely possible.
Well, you are living proof.
Oh, I mean, I'm just kind of a dork and just like sat around and studied a lot. Like, it's not hard if you have nothing else to do, you know?
Can we all just agree that we're all dorks?
A little bit. Yeah.
That's good. That's why we belong together.
That's true. Okay, who's next?
Happy.
Happy. Hey,
guys. So I am here currently in Hawaii. It's really pretty and it's like 2 p.m. So I have been learning Chinese for like 7 years or so, like 8 years maybe. And I have a little background here. This is my little Xie Zhiqian. And then,
by the way, with your background.
Thank you. No, yeah, it's actually my like creative corner. So this is where I like do a lot of my editing and all of that. And so I first started learning Chinese because I made a ton of Chinese friends on a college campus. So a bunch of Chinese exchange student friends. Then I studied abroad in Japan and made a lot of Chinese exchange student friends again, and then also traveled independently in China for 7 months and also studied abroad in Shanghai for a semester. And then I've been there like every year. It's been a ton of fun. And so I love Chinese music. It's just KTV is my everything. I love KTV, just like singing at karaoke,
yeah, oh my God,
like with Chinese. Yes, and I've learned so much music because of KTV. So yeah, it's just a wonderful way to bond with people and also to bond with so many different kind of like generations and to really understand like a person and their tastes like through the music that they listen to. So just really being able to connect with people. And I love singing as well, so there's that too. But yeah, so that's me.
Oh my gosh, I love that. I completely agree. I think that music really does connect people in so many ways. And I love how you bring up KTV, because that's like that's just such an amazing way to be with people and just really, you know, express a lot of passion. Because I love it.
Music is the international language. There's just no doubt about it. We all understand a nice melody.
Mm.
Totally. I agree with that.
Yeah, okay. Karaoke is like my favorite thing in the entire world.
Yes.
Yeah, I absolutely love it. Especially because, I mean, we'll probably get into this on a deeper level, obviously, soon. But I think particularly, I mean, obviously, I think it's really good for learning any language to begin with. But then even more than that, I think sort of when you have some kind of a foundation, there's just something so beautiful about being able to understand lyrics. I guess you could say like more abstract lyrics on a deeper level. Yeah. It's really nice, and like it's so interesting, especially with Chinese, right? Because fewer characters can express so much more than we usually can in English. So that's like the craziest thing, and that's really hard to explain to people who don't speak Chinese, like they don't understand that, you know. But so for anyone who's watching and is like, "Why should I study Chinese?" That's why, because when you get to a point where you can understand these lyrics, it's like the craziest thing. Yeah, my mom just made comments. My mom is so supportive, you guys. Like she's just always here. She said henshen, so she's saying that like the are very deep, right? So, feichanggaren, right, mom?
So,
okay, that's enough of me.
That's awesome. My mom is here too, actually. My mom
is here. Love that. All the moms.
Yeah. Hi, Laurier's mom.
Hi,
Laurier's mom. Her name is Lizette.
What?
Lizette.
Her name is Lizette.
Well, that's a pretty name.
Pretty name.
Oh, and by the way, my mom in the comments said your name is really pretty. So you're French, obviously. You guys are French.
Yes.
French Canadians.
Well spotted.
Yeah. All right, closer to the mic.
Happy, you're the person who has to tell me these things. Thank you.
I'm saying hi to the new people. Hello, everybody. My mom says, "Jiayou, Laurier's mom." Okay. Laurier's mom. Lizette, mom. It was Lizette. Okay.
What I love about learning Chinese is that I understand the lyrics of the songs that I like more and more as I become better and better. Because I love so many of the Chinese songs that I love, not because of the lyrics, it's because of what they're doing musically. Mm-hmm. And the lyrics is right now a small component of that. And I'm understanding the meaning behind my songs more and more as I go. It's really, really cool.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, my God, that's so true. Once you add like the deeper meaning when you hear the lyrics and stuff, like sometimes a melody just really gets you out, you know? When I first started learning Chinese, like it was always just the melody, because I didn't know like Chinese, right?
For sure.
And once you are learning, it just means something else and you're like, whoa. So either you like it more or maybe you like it a little bit less, but either way.
That's it. 100%. So true.
Yes. Well, okay, I guess let me introduce myself really quick and then we'll get out the actual.
Who's that girl?
People watching.
Get out.
Rip. Okay, so hi everyone. My name is Jen. I live in Canada too, but I live on the other side of Canada, the Laurier. And I've been learning Chinese for almost 3 years now. And I just really love Chinese music. I love music in general. And like, you know, singing like Changgu, I just really like to, you know, just throw a little bit in there.
Me too.
So I like a little bit, you know. So yeah, that's basically me. Anyway, so that's my slight introduction. So I guess the main first question that we have to talk about is just basically like learning Chinese and through music. So I'm just curious about for you guys. Did you use music to learn Chinese? I mean, we kind of talked about it a little bit. Like, what were your strategies for using the music to learn Chinese? Let's start with Happy.
Okay, so this is a very interesting question because I think that it really depends on the kind of music that you listen to. Mm. I've been learning for like 7-8 years, yeah? But then there's so many kinds of Chinese music that are very like 文言文 or like really poetic.
to the point of like 5,000 years ago kind of thing. Because like DJ said, they have like 5,000 years worth of history that they're able to put into lyrics. And I'm just like, quack. Like, there's a lot that I still don't know, like, because of the, like, historical context of it. So, like, 古风歌曲, or, like the more traditional music, or, like, 京剧, I would have no idea.
京剧 is the worst. Yeah. That's, okay, that's Chinese opera, guys. It's the worst.
Beijing opera.
Bad.
It's the best, but it's also so rich. It's so rich, just like you were saying, JJ, like, it's so rich that you can't just understand it without having this like huge like research behind it. So like if it's about more of kind of like love songs or things that are more literal or kind of more tangible, then it's easier. But then when you start getting into certain songs that start like they're like using analogies and they're using like 比如, like the different like ways to express like something that means something else. Like Shi Jiqian has a song 动物世界 that took that's about like the animal kingdom, and so many like every animal mean is representing something different of society, and it's so deep. But then that's also how I've been able to learn a lot of Chinese like with guidance through those lyrics. So I think they're like really simple lyrics to be able to learn. And I've also seen a lot of songs, like even at KTV, I've gotten to the point that I'm able to kind of go along with the melody and also read the lyrics of a song, kind of like, because a lot of those lyrics have been like used before, or I've seen them in other songs before. So I think that they really do stack on themselves until you hit a Zhou Jieluan song, and then it's like, nope, throw everything out the window. Like, oh, it's just too hard.
Man, that is actually such a good point. Zhou Jieluan, like, he goes crazy. He wilds out sometimes with those lyrics. It can be really
so true. But yeah, so that's my little background of learning Chinese through lyrics.
Love that. Okay, so who's next? Let's go with JJ.
Okay, yeah. Let me think. I remember when I first started learning Chinese, it was super frustrating because I got sort of interested in the music pretty early on. And it was really frustrating for me because I would, you know, listen to these songs and I would go to KTV with my friends and I didn't understand anything that was going on. I mean, understandably, right? When you can only read five words on a menu, obviously you weren't going to be able to understand deeper lyrics of a Chinese love song. So that was really obnoxious. I remember just getting over that initial hump. It was very, very frustrating. But then sort of over time, I just kind of kept listening and kept studying, obviously. And it was what was really wonderful is you do get to a point where you find yourself understanding more and more, and you're reading the lyrics and you're listening to the songs and you're like, you know, just a few months ago, I didn't understand this song at all. So I think for me, it was a really good way for me to gauge that I was actually improving. You know, like I would listen to a song that I really liked and then listen to it again 3-4 months later and actually be able to read the lyrics. So for me, it was actually really good motivation for me to keep up with my studies because I actually, it was an actual way I could observe my improvement. Does that make sense? Like something like, okay, like 具体, like what is that? Concrete. Yeah, it was like a concrete way for me to see that I was actually making progress. And that was really amazing for me. So Chinese songs were really great in that sense for me. I'm rambling, but you get the idea.
I completely agree. Like, because if you start out from kind of knowing not much, and then all of a sudden you're learning, and if you even study the song and you start to understand deeper meanings that way, it's so nice. Yeah. Even like for myself too. Like for example, so I have my cue cards here. Like one day I'll be studying cue cards and I'll just be like, whoa, this word like sounds familiar, and then I'll remember a phrase in a song and I'll be like, whoa, now I know how to use it and what it means. And then I'll just keep remembering that line of the song to remember that one. Like it really sticks in there. So I just find that really interesting, and it's kind of a fun way to, I guess, remember different words. And also it just makes you feel really good too when it's like, yes, I know what it means. Like it's just
yes.
Laurier, how about you? Talk to us. Let us know.
Yeah, like a little bit like JJ, I kind of use it as you said a word and I forgot it, but it's like a way to evaluate
like
yourself.
Concretely evaluate progress, right?
Yeah, yeah. You just listen to a song that you listened to 2 months ago and you see how much more you understand. It's really cool. I think from Chinese music, I think I've learned more about songwriting than I did Chinese, because I think I pay more attention to music than lyrics.
Oh, see, I'm the opposite. I'm a lyric person.
Yeah. There you go. Yeah. Don't get me wrong. I love really good lyrics as well. But with Chinese, it's like I got so used to the sound of a Chinese singer that Chinese singing has kind of become just an instrument I'm used to hearing. Like, we all know what a piano sounds like. We all know what a guitar sounds like. Like, Chinese voice, it just sounds familiar. It doesn't sound foreign. Even when I don't know what they're saying, it doesn't sound like, oh, this is weird and abstract. It's just like I'm listening to it and it's just part of the mix and the harmony and just like the production. And when I listen to Jay Cho songs or Jem mm-hmm. songs or Hebe songs, like, I'm taking notes about how I can write better English songs. So learning Chinese from the lyrics themselves, I do that a little bit, but that's not my main way to learn. Like, I'm more like JJ, where I'll go back to the lyrics and evaluate myself and see how much I understand now, you know?
Yeah, I completely agree. I think the other thing I was gonna say, sorry, I'm just responding to comments. I want engagement to be good. So guys, write comments to us.
Yeah, right. I'm not even set up for responding to comments.
Well, then you can get out.
I can what?
Get out.
I can get out.
No, I'm just kidding. I'm kidding. No, stay. I'm just joking. No, but I was going to say the thing about the lyrics too. So I'm sort of more of, I guess, you know, just kind of expanding on your point about how you're sort of more musically interested. I think that's amazing too. I feel like but you're an actual musician, right? So I feel like I can't appreciate it in the same way because I don't really understand musically how things work. Jen, I would say the same with you, you know, because, you know, you can play guitar and everything as well. But what I really like, I feel like I'm sort of in some ways, I think I'm like a very romantic person. And I think that, the Chinese lyrics are often very, very romantic. So I think that's why I'm so lyrically oriented. Yeah. But I do appreciate people that are more musically oriented as well.
I feel like you could totally get into music theory and arrangement.
Oh my gosh.
And you would just like get good at it so fast.
Really? No, I don't think so. I mean, I appreciate that. I appreciate the hype, but probably not. But thank you.
I just feel like you're really hardworking and you just set your mind to stuff.
Oh, no, that's actually not true. As I mentioned earlier, I'm actually not that hardworking. I'm really not. I'm like actually really not. I wish I was more hardworking. That's actually one of the things I don't like about myself. The thing is, it's just, no, it's true. I think it's just like, if you like something, you dedicate more time to it. And so I really like Chinese. You guys know what I mean? Like, when you like something.
Yeah,
that's right. Yeah, you'll put more effort into that. I get that.
Exactly. And it doesn't feel like work, you know?
Okay. Yeah. I totally get that. I think, yeah, when you are passionate, you really feel like it, like learning more about it. Yeah. For example, I'm still a student and I'm still in school and I'm not as passionate about, let's say, finance as I am. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Chinese direction, just like a little bit more, but you know, I'm in school, I've got to study, fine, I'll do it, you know, but anyway, yeah. But okay, I needed to quickly mention to everybody watching, if you guys don't already know, like everybody here does sing in Chinese and like make music and that kind of thing. So for example, like JJ does the most beautiful covers of these amazing songs, like her voice is unreal. So if you haven't checked her out, you need to. Laurier literally like writes music. He's coming out with an album soon and like
really?
Covers in Chinese and duets with people on TikTok and Douyin. Like this dude's like amazing. And then Happy here, wow, like I literally need to take a deep breath or something because this girl can sing. You know what I mean? So I just feel like if you guys don't already know, you need to go and listen to everybody's music here because it's just unreal. Like literally every single person here. And I love how we're also interested in like Chinese music too. It just kind of adds a little bit of a little like spin or something onto like ooh, like it's kind of fun. Like, ooh, they sing in Chinese sometimes. Like, oh, hi. Yeah, so love that. Okay, so.
Someone wants us to sing, by the way. You guys see that in the comments? Oh, we will sing. We will sing. We promise.
And also, we need to remember that Jen has written her own Chinese song. Like, you are also this amazing
inspiration.
Come on, Jen. You can't, like, leave that out. Come
Do you want to hear a secret? Do you want to hear a secret?
Yeah, you didn't say that. What? No, we wanted a secret.
What? Okay, what? My secret is that it is recorded, and I will be releasing it on Spotify and on Chinese music apps. So that's coming in September. So that's for y'all watching, okay? So it's not like well written or anything, though. I need to make that because I'm not fluent, okay? So it's not like well written. I think it's like a bop. It's a little bit of a bop. It makes me want to smile, I think. But anyway,
it's a bop. It's a bop.
The melody is really, really nice.
Hey!
And that's the music man. You heard it here first from the music man. The melody is nice.
Thank you, music man.
You heard me harmonize to it.
Yeah. He sent me a DM and he was like harmonizing towards it. And I was like, oh, that's good.
You should include some of those harmonies in your final recording if you don't have them already.
Oh, I already have everything. But you know what?
Next time.
I'll get the instrumentals too. And we'll make it happen. Okay.
Yeah. Let's do it.
Amazing. Okay. So guys, this is where this live stream really gets fun, okay? Everyone here has prepared their three favorite Chinese musicians. And we are going to share with you our faves, okay? We have prepared a little power, well, like, kind of. We're just gonna introduce them to you, okay? So, are you guys ready? If we missed anyone that you like, by the way, you guys gotta let us know. Like, fill this chat with people that you love so that we can have new music to listen to as well, okay? So just make sure that you really, get involved here. Tell us your thoughts. But anyway, let's start with Laurier this time. Let's figure out how to share your screen here. If you want to do that.
We know how to do that.
Yeah. We're all trying to do this live thing, so we're working on it. Yeah.
This is going to be so much fun. Look
at that.
We are. Ooh. Introduce your fave musicians. Wait, you have
before. No, Shuang Yi. Oh, Hong Dong. Okay.
Where'd it go?
Hold on. Where'd it go? I'm lost.
Here, go to the presentation. Yeah.
Yeah, I gotta go back. I just lost it. I'm not gonna do full screen anymore, I don't think.
No worries. You know, technology sometimes really gets the best of us, but we're working on it.
Let's do it.
Do you see me?
Oh, yeah. Yes, we can see you, but we need to see your presentation. Audit.
Oh, yeah.
Ta-da!
Oh, Jem.
Okay, talk to us, Maria.
Listen, I'm going
to
talk about Jem, but you guys definitely know some stuff about Jem that I don't, you know? Like, I'm not an expert. I just really like her music. So if you ask me, the exact moment she was born, the exact hospital, I'm not going to know that. But I just really, really like her music. And I was introduced to Jem at a KTV in Singapore, hanging out with a friend. She pulled up the music video for Light Years Away, Guangyang Zhuai. And it just blew my freaking mind. Like watching that video, because you know at KTV in Asia, you can, I guess maybe everywhere, but for sure in Asia, you can have the option to have the lyrics be going with the song or not. So this time we were just chilling, eating food, and then she put this music video up and I'm just watching this. I was blown away. I was like, oh my God, the goosebumps are so real for a first listen too. Because songs will often grow on me like Guangyang Zhuai did. But this one was like instant love. Like I was just so into it. I'm like, who the heck is this girl? I need to check out all of her music. What the heck is going on? I was so into it. Guangyang Zhuai. Like that intro is so haunting.
Whoa.
And from that moment on, I was just in love. I need to just listen to all of her music. I downloaded her album that she dropped in 2019, December, City Zoo. And I just love every single song on that album. And I know a bunch of her other hits. And at some point, I think she's going to know who I am. That's my goal anyways.
Yes.
Next.
Yes. Worthy goal. Do it.
Next. Totally. We can talk more about Jem later, but the show going.
Like,
boom. Who's that?
Marcus!
Yay!
Oh,
that's
enough. So that is my good friend Marcus, who I met randomly on a ship one time.
That is so
And he asked me if he could sing with me, and I said, okay. And he came up to me with his buddy Benjamin, who's a really, really good piano player. But I didn't know that. I didn't know them at all. They come up to me, they go, "You're the piano guy, right?" I'm like, "Yeah." They're like, "Can we perform? We swear we're good." I'm just like, "Okay.
Sure. Swear we're good.
Show me what you got." And then they just like blow the crowd away. And then Marcus and I started just singing together and doing harmonies. Like I would be like, "Okay, sing a harmony." Boom. He sings a harmony. Perfect. I'm like, "Hey, sing a lower harmony." Boom. Sings a lower harmony. He's just like so quick. And I'm like, "Yeah, I'm going to be friends with this guy for sure." And turns out I just really like his music, and he's not known everywhere in China or in the world yet. But the thing is that he totally has potential to be. And if I didn't know him, I would be a huge fan, because his songwriting to me is on freaking point. I am so into it. And we did a cover on YouTube, so you can go check it out, of Shimmy and Facing Insomnia Flight. Mm-hmm. It's on Marcus's channel. You can check it out if you want. But straight up, he's just one of my favorite artists. I can't even lie. Next. You ready?
Yeah. We're ready.
And finally, we've got Hebe.
She is such a babe. Yeah, of course.
Yeah. Hebe, I don't know a whole bunch of her songs by names, but I've got a playlist of her songs, and two of her songs specifically I perform on Ships. Her songwriting, and I don't even know if she writes her own songs, but she's probably part of it, and I don't even care, really. It's just the music that I hear that comes out of her is so smart. Like the chords that she's going to play, like, oh my God, do you know the song Xiao Xin Yun? You know that song, guys? Yo, that song, Xiao Xin Yun, is so musically smart. And okay, maybe someone who plays jazz is going to hear it and like, yeah, that's pretty normal stuff. But it's like for pop music, it's not like I don't hear stuff like that on the radio, like in top 40s in Canada. So like Xiao Xin Yun, wait a minute, where is that?
I do know that song. Oh, that's
so
good one.
Nice.
That's a beautiful
song. It's so nice. 我听见雨滴落在青青草地，我听见远方下个钟声响起。 可是我没有听见你的声音，认真呼唤我姓名。
Good.
And that's perfect.
Yeah!
Oh, I love it. Oh, we're getting some real singing in. I'm so excited.
Angel Devil is my second favorite song by Hebe. It's
sing that one.
So haunting. You want to hear a little bit?
Yes.
Yeah.
We want to hear it.
Okay, hold on. Let me find the lyrics. JJ, do you know that song?
No. Well, no, I mean, I don't
But I see the sun jing a tiao, hui bu hui bi jiao shui de zhang, o de xin. 有座灰色的监牢，让这一票黑色念头在吼叫。A little bit more. 把家人的脾气抽掉，会不会比较被明了？你可以重重把我给打倒。 Okay, one chorus and then we're going to the next person. Yeah! Yeah!
从眼里流下谢谢两个字，尽管叫我疯子，不准叫我傻子。And next on the podium, we've got Happy.
Well, that was good. That was quite a transition. That was good.
That was so good. That was
professional.
That was amazing.
That was wonderful. That was so good.
I'm over here. Thank you for listening. I'm a fangirl, and then you just put me on the spot like that. Okay. You want me to be next?
Okay.
Okay. Okay. Okay. Let me collect myself because there's another wave of fangirling getting ready to.
Oh, guys, my mom just sent me a heart.
Oh, Lizette, that's cute, girl. That is cute.
My mom definitely laughed out loud when she heard you say her name. I know my mom, and she would have been like, oh! And she probably just laughed again right now for me doing that. So anyways, Happy.
Okay, Happy, I'm adding your slide. Here we are.
Dun, 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 dun.
Wow, that is really fancy. That is good. That is
Actually, Happy should have probably gone last.
Yeah.
Like, I'm sorry.
To be honest. Honestly, sorry, like, JJ and Jen.
Yeah.
Come on, Lori.
She probably should have gone last. That's okay.
I'm sorry, guys. Okay.
No, that's all right. You know, upstaging us as per always.
So I will definitely have a lot of energy into this, though. So you guys will probably be much more level-headed and much more easy to consume. So
I have a little presentation for these three amazing people. Da-da-da-da-da-da! You probably can't recognize them that well because these are really funny. I just found these pictures that I thought, those are interesting pictures. So let's use those.
So cool.
They look good together.
Yeah,
I know, right?
That's like a group. And a half. So, legends of Chinese pop music.
Whee! Got it. Okay.
So first, of course, you have to have Zhou Jielun or Jay Chou. I have little facts about him here. So, for example, he was born in like 79, which means he's 41 years old.
Okay.
He was born in Xinbei, and then he's a Copernicus. I don't know how to say that.
A Capricorn.
Capricorn. He's a Capricorn.
Capricorn.
All right. He's Capricorn.
Yeah. And then the little background music, Lori. Okay. And then he is 175 centimeters tall.
Okay.
So he debuted in 2000. That's 20 years ago, my friend. So what does he do? He does everything. So he's a singer, songwriter, record producer, rapper, and then overall god of music. So I've heard that he is like the equivalent of like the Michael Jackson of China is how like it was explained to like Westerners to try and have like an idea of who he is. So also Zhou Jielun, he does this amazing like fusion of music. So he does like R&B, rap, pop, classical music, traditional Chinese, and basically everything under the sun. And what's interesting about him too is that he just really like makes everything so beautifully poetic.
Yeah.
Like his lyrical abilities are amazing. So he's basically on the level of like Confucius, like that kind of like feeling, like Wen Yu Wen. Like, he's got over 300 songs in like, and he's constantly breaking the internet. He was, for example, with like, "说好不哭," like it just broke YouTube. He also broke the internet by being the most talked about like topic on Weibo when he doesn't even have a Weibo account. He just has an Instagram. He also broke the internet by having like being the first like starring in the first like Chinese language reality TV show on Netflix, which is his own. And then he also represents multiple generations. So he's never gotten old. Like, the new generations love him. The old generations love him. Like, everybody has their own, like for my generation, a generation older than me, like, it feels that everybody really has, like, a like certain albums, certain songs that just really, like, get to them. So I feel that every Chinese speaker at some point in time has cried and also stumbled over a rap of Zhou Jielun's at some point in time. So that is Zhou Jielun. Now, on to He is one of the most famous like ABCs, so American born Chinese. He is a Taurus and was born in 76. So he is 44 years old and doesn't look it. It is so unfair. So he was born in New York, but then he was able to like go into like a be under a Chinese record label. And so he also is this just phenomenal like awesomeness. So he is like singer, songwriter, actor, producer, filmmaker. He's done over like 20 different movies, over 200 songs, bridging East and West. And he also does a form of fusion, but then more of brings kind of a Western feel or Western lyrical kind of like feel to like Chinese like sounds as well. It's so cool. So he'll also do like traditional Chinese music and everything on the earth, like, and bring it together. And is just really revolutionary in his like musical ability. So I actually had the honor of singing with him on Chinese TV one time.
Whoa! I know that.
Yeah, so legendary. So I was on a Chinese, so I had the honor of just singing with him on a Chinese TV show. And so I actually have a video about that coming up this weekend. So be ready, excited for that. And now, without further ado,
okay, the best for last, am I right?
Look at that outfit. I love that outfit.
Right? He's okay. Can we just talk? Okay, so Xu Jiqian. So he's like a little bit younger, yeah? So he's more of like the Jiuling Ho, so the after 90s generation. So he was born in 83. He is only a little like 37. He's a Cancer like me. And so he's 172 centimeters. And then he debuted in 2006. So he's kind of like the a more recent generation of artists. He's also from Shanghai, which is why I've learned a ton of Shanghainese. I got to study abroad in his like hometown, which was wonderful. Well, hometown meaning like home province.
Yeah.
Yep. So Xu Jiqian, a few more pictures than the other guys, but singer, songwriter, record producer, fashion brand. He has his own hot pot restaurant. That is how awesome he is. And then he's also a comedian. Like, he's so funny. He's been on tons of shows, tons of TV shows. He's also an amazing actor. He's just really, like a comedic genius and a lyrical genius. Like, he is known also as, like, the ballad king of the 90s generation, whereas Zhang Xinzhe would have been the 80s ballad king. So he's also experimented with different kinds of, like, music. Like, he used to do just more piano based, but then he's like really kind of tried out like different sounds, like just very inventive in that way as well. He has over 80 songs, so he's still like a little bit like you can't really compare him directly with the other two, but in his own way he's just extremely phenomenal. My favorite singer of all time. I have a little cutout of him right here. I have my like sticker from Xu Jiqian Zhou Mo Tian Da Lou Zhou 2018, like from his Yanchangkui. So I've been to two of his concerts. One was in Shanghai in 2017, and then one of them was over in San Jose, California, in 2018, where he noticed me. Yay! And so we got to have a conversation in Shanghainese, which is pretty fun. So,
no way.
He knows I exist.
Cool. Right.
So my favorite picture here actually is the one where he's holding the mic and he's waving, because this picture was taken when he saw me in the crowd.
He was waving at you.
I might possibly have that as the background of some platforms, but yes, that is the big 2.5 legends of Chinese pop music.
Amazing. Absolutely love it.
Okay, well, I can't top that. So can someone else go first? Jen, can you go? Let me go last.
I'm so sorry. Okay, sure. I can go. Okay, let me set it up here. Okay,
Was that okay? Was it too loud or too soft?
No, it was perfect.
It was perfect. It was just the right sound.
So if I know the song or if I know the artist, I should just like go just for it.
Yeah.
I feel like, JJ, I don't know any of yours. I don't think so.
My taste is strange. So that's fine.
I'm excited to learn about it, though. You know,
I don't even know that much, to be honest. But we'll see how it goes.
No worries. Okay. Okay. Let me share my screen here. Okay. So, Maui. Okay. This guy. Hopefully y'all have heard of him because he's just like, look at him. He's the cutest thing.
He's so adorable.
Right?
Look at that soft little round face. He's adorable.
So cute. So why do I like him so much? Let me tell you, his music is complicated. So let me try to describe it to you. Like, I feel like I describe it to many people.
Okay.
So you picture yourself on a beach and you're wearing like a white hat, like a white linen hat, and you hear the ocean sounds and like the sand is like underneath you. Like, it's just, it's the most beautiful feeling, right? Oh, and birds chirping in the background and the wind going through grass. Do you feel it? Do you feel it?
I'm feeling it.
Good.
I'm already there.
See, that is
very intense.
This is how his music makes me feel. It is cool.
You really so beautiful. I'm impressed.
So my favorite song is this, Ping Fan De Yi Tian. And I did a cover of this on my channel already, but I can't, like, I love this song. Oh, it is so beautiful. And
oh, God.
Yeah. Anyway, I just love it because it's always like his music is just very calm. And it just makes you really feel wholesome. And like, it just makes you feel like the sun is shining on your face, basically. So anyway, oh yeah. So these are just some songs. I just put them down here in case anybody wants to check out his music. These are some of my favorites or just some of his popular ones. So that's just there that you can, you know, just write it down or whatever. Okay, thank you.
Jen.
What? Yeah.
Would you be willing to grab your guitar and sing one of his songs for us?
Oh, people are so excited.
Did you tune before the stream?
I got my guitar, okay?
Nichamba. Sing for us.
Okay. I'm gonna do Ping Fan De Yi Tian because that's the only one I know how to play on guitar. Can you hear it okay?
Yes.
Okay, good. Yeah, okay. I can barely remember how to play it. There we go. Okay. There's some of it.
Oh, that was beautiful.
Loved it.
Yay, okay, glad you liked it. Yes.
Sweet voice. Oh my gosh, so pretty.
Get out of town. Okay.
My mom loved it. She says Han Hao Ping. My mom is she's a big fan.
Oh wow, thank you guys. I feel out of practice. Okay. So anyway, he's just very chill, very relaxing. Absolutely love him. Every single one of his songs just puts me in a good mood. Okay, number two, the OG. The absolute OG, Eric Cho, my man. He does.
That's nice. That's cute.
There's a few things about Eric Cho that we have to realize. First of all, he has delicious music. Like, it's just it's lovely, first of all. A lot of his songs have been put into dramas, and they're just lovely. Number two,
okay,
Instagram persona is the funniest thing. He's so, okay, literally, I have to find his latest post because his caption was just two words, but I laughed out loud because it was just hilarious to me. So,
oh my God.
I love people that are funny on Instagram. Those are my
favorites.
Yes.
I'm so excited. Okay, show.
But to be honest, my sense of humor is also just really weird. So maybe that could also be it. So this is his photo, right? He's just chilling.
Uh-huh. Right?
And the caption is mirror snaps.
What is it?
Mirror snaps, like a snapshot.
Mirror snaps.
I just think it's hilarious. It's really not that funny, but I think it's hilarious. But anyway, I'm going to turn red because really, okay.
You know what it is? It's funny because it doesn't really make sense, but he still posted it for like millions of people. Like, I don't care. Like, that's why it's funny. He's just like, okay, post. It's done. That's why it's funny.
It's amazing. What I love about him too is that he posts music videos like there's no tomorrow. It's like every few weeks there's a new music video, a new song, and he also posts vlogs on YouTube every once in a while. Just like Jem, actually, because they both post vlogs. So I like watching those. They're another way that I like to learn. But anyway, these are some of my favorite songs by him, and you guys should check him out if you don't already know his existence.
I actually really don't know that well, so I'm ashamed. Full of embarrassment. I'll look it up. I'll look him up.
No, girl. Wait,
did anybody else think that he was related to Jay Joe for some reason?
Oh, because the Joe, right?
Yeah.
He's got the same last name, so that's a fair, it's definitely a fair guess.
It is fair.
I just felt like it's just like Jessica Simpson and Ashley Simpson, you know, family.
All right, yeah, I totally get that. I
don't want to compare J.Cho to Jessica Simpson. No offense to anybody. No offense to anybody.
Jessica Simpson is my cousin. No, I'm just kidding. I'm offended. I'm just kidding. No, that's fair. She fell off, didn't she? Okay, moving on.
I don't know. I don't want to do that.
I'm dying. Okay. Yes, so next up. The one, the only. Now, okay, so
happy.
Hua Hua. Okay, I have a story.
Hua Hua. Oh, he's so cute. He's got a little bit of a feminine energy. I like it. It's cute.
He's actually very hardcore.
Okay. Oh, actually, no, that's true. I was looking up some of his videos today. He is actually really hardcore. You're right.
But you know what? He's cool. So I respect him. Like, this is a guy that I respect because he's so talented in multiple areas. Not only does he write songs, but I went into his family. I went into his history, okay? My friends, they educated me a little bit on his history. Okay. And it's dramatic, but it's quite, like it really makes me appreciate the music all the more. Now, he has a song that maybe I can show you guys later, but it is, like, that's just one song that really, like, gets me going. Like, it makes you feel things because it's just so emotional. Mm-hmm. Like, I'll give you guys the titles later because, you know, we have a game coming up later, okay? And I'm going to just play. I don't know if we'll get to all of the points in the game, but, you know, we'll try.
We'll do our best.
Yes. So anyway, he's just fantastic. He was on this show called Singer, and he just did so many covers of songs, and I listened to his albums, and they're all really just, they're just lovely. He has a great voice and great talent, so really respect him. Anyway, so that's my little section. Thank you for listening.
Thank you for coming to my talk. That was great. Gosh, you guys all did a really good job on this. Someone says, will this be live? Okay, yes. Someone is saying they have to go. Okay, yes, it will be uploaded. You can go.
You can go.
No, we will miss you. It's too bad you have to go. But yes, this will be up once this is done. So, I mean, yeah, once this is over, it will be uploaded. So you can check it out.
And after JJ's presentation, why don't we do like a quick 5-minute comment break, like where we just read a few comments and stuff?
Oh, okay. That's a good idea.
We respond to people who are talking.
Yeah, that's we're trying to reply in there, but I agree. Let's just talk to people. This is good. So JJ.
Then don't go. Okay. I'm sorry. I'm reading more comments. Okay. So yes, I did not do a PowerPoint presentation, which, you know, they already knew. I let them know beforehand. I don't know how to do that, which is kind of funny, but I actually really don't. So I didn't do one, but I do have, I figure I can Wikipedia them and I can kind of wing it as I go. The thing about me is I feel sort of bad because I definitely don't, there isn't really a particular singer I fangirl out over in the same way you guys do. So I feel sort of like, I'm the odd man out in that sense.
I'm a total fangirl.
See, yeah, you're like a Gem fangirl. Like, I'm not really a huge fangirl, really. Like, yeah, just as a general rule, that's never been like a thing I've attached myself onto. I don't know why. But okay, actually, but you know, I didn't write this down, but I did remember like maybe like 8 or 9 years ago. I think recently he's had a scandal. I'm not actually sure of the particulars of it. Maybe you guys know. There is a singer that I really, really loved like 8, 9 years ago. But yeah, I think there was some kind of scandal. And that is Luo Zhixiang. Luo Zhixiang. Do you guys know Xiao Zhu? Luo Zhixiang.
Okay.
Luo Zhixiang. You have a picture of him?
Well, yeah. Let me do my, can we do the screen sharing thing? So that's Google Translate. I was looking up, for those who just saw, I was looking at the tones for Fei Yuqing just to make sure I said it right. But so how do we do this so I can like show you a picture? Do I just like find it here? And okay, yeah. I'll do it right now. So it's Luo Zhixiang. So he had this like TV show a while ago. Like, yeah, like 8 or 9 years ago. Yeah, okay, so he did have a scandal. See, it's right here. So let me see if I can share my screen. Okay. It's not that. Okay, and then let me share screen. 1 minute, y'all. Please be patient. We're having...
You got it.
Where is it? Where is it? I'm sorry, guys, everybody. Oh, here it is. Okay, there we go. So this is Luo Zhixiang. You know, he didn't age the best. I'll be real with you. I'll be honest. But yeah, he was like, I was really, really obsessed. Yeah, see, I think there was some sort of a scandal or something.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I'm not really sure if I'm allowed to like him anymore. But I did. I really, really did. Yeah, see, there's like a scandal with this girl for sure. I see. Something's going on. For anyone who knows in the comments, please let us know what the scandal is involving this woman. Yeah, I'm not really sure what's going on, but you know, I haven't listened to his music in a really long time. But I would say, as far as fangirling goes, I was really, really obsessed with him about 8 or 9 years ago because I thought he was like really funny and all that. Mm-hmm. Can you guys see my screen? I don't know how this works. You can't see it, right?
Nope.
Okay, good, good, good. So yeah, I really liked him. I thought he was so funny. Mm-hmm. But yeah, I haven't listened to his stuff in a really, really long time. And actually, someone asked in the comments a while ago. It's so funny. Someone with Google Translate. Yeah, sometimes I use Google Translate, you guys. I think someone asked in the comments at some point. Yeah, oh, Xiao Zhu. Yeah, that's right. That's his nickname. Mm-hmm. So yeah, Xiao Zhu, little pig, is his nickname. So anyway, someone asked in the comments a while ago as well, are there any celebrities we've met or we've seen in person or anything like that? And you guys have some good stories. So I actually did see him in person at a movie theater about 8 years ago. And I did freak out. I definitely did. Because he was like actually like quite tall and handsome.
Fangirl.
I did have a fangirl moment, and I was with some friends who knew that he was like my favorite artiste of the moment. So they like all dragged me to go say hi to him, and of course I like, yeah, I know. And so I did, but I was just like, just it wasn't cute. Like, it wasn't a good look. Like, he was
your Chinese good
at the time? At that point, it wasn't that good. So I think he was basically just like, he was very nice, but it was clearly just like, okay, cool. Like, I want to watch my movie now. Like, get out of my face.
You have a picture?
No, I wasn't about to ask for a picture. That's too embarrassing. I didn't want to ruin this man's night.
I feel you.
I was way too embarrassed. But so yeah, that was like the only, so I would say Luo Zhixiang is the only celebrity I really did fangirl over at some point. As far as singers now, so usually I am more of like I'm more of like a song by song girl, and I always have been. So like the singer in and of themselves doesn't really matter to me that much. But you know, I do really like, you guys who watch my channel might know, I nerd out over classical Chinese music, or sort of like older generation Chinese music. I really do. So you guys just saw it on Google Translate. I really do like Fei Yuqing. I think he's phenomenal. I can like show you guys. You all show like hot young people. I have just like.
You're going to show hot old people.
I'm going to show really hot old people. Yeah. I'm going to show super hot old people. So I hope that's okay, because I'm
yes, please.
Not as cool as you guys. So you guys, this is Fei Yuqing. Yeah, see, someone said Xiaozhu has been canceled. Okay, okay, so can you explain why in the comments why Xiaozhu has been canceled? Because I don't know the scandal. I don't know what's going on. I did really love him, so it's such a shame. I don't know what's going on. So anyway, so Fei Yuqing is a, he sings a lot of sort of classical Chinese songs. For people who are familiar with Jay Chou, he sings with Jay Chou the, what is it? That one? He sings, you know that? Oh, he was having, oh no. Okay.
Yeah, so might not want to read those comments.
I'm not going to read it. I'm not going to read it
now. But, you know, now. Yep.
I'm not going to read out loud, but what a shame. You know, you like, see, I'm seeing on the list that apparently, I mean, I'm seeing on the comments that apparently he did some bad things. Mm. Oh, heart is shattered, you know? I'm so disappointed.
Yeah, he used to be like really popular on Douyin as well. Like when Douyin was first, like he was the first one. I remember really liking his one song. I loved that.
I'm so disappointed. Oh, my childhood dreams. Okay, my mom says move on. I'm moving on. So Fei Yuqing, I'll show you guys quickly. I'm going to share the screen with you guys so you can see who Fei Yuqing is. One second. And then you'll see what I mean. So he's not the youngest man. Can you guys see?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. So this is Fei Yuqing. So yeah, if you guys are familiar, he recently had like this meme song, which was the EDMA. That was the that one. Okay, but yeah, I'm a little nervous. But yeah, so I really like all of his music a lot. And even before, you know, Shui Hua Piao Piao really blew up, I was a really big fan of his. Once it did become like this meme song, I definitely took advantage of that situation and filmed something as soon as I possibly could because I really like his music. And so let's move on. So another one I like, I don't know how well known she is. Her English name is Lexi Liu and her Chinese name is Liu Baixin. You guys know Liu Baixin. So I'm a big fan. I'll show you guys Liu Baixin quickly. She's from Tianjin originally. And I think she's phenomenal. One minute, you guys.
She did the Liang Liang, right?
I don't even. Did she do that? I don't really know. I'm not as familiar as you guys are. I'm really embarrassed.
That's the only song that I know. I only know her like that one song.
Me too.
But no, yeah, but I love that you know her. Oh my gosh, that's so cool.
I'm a big fan. I'm gonna quickly share my screen with you guys so you can see what she looks like. She looks really cool too. Like she looks just like a person you would want to be friends with because she's so cool. So this is her, Lexi Liu. So yeah, she's really like, I don't know, there's something about her, like her energy, her vibe is just so cool. Whoa. I really like her. She's so cool looking, right? And like, I think for China too, this is like so kind of, I don't know, like, I mean, I think you're starting to see this style in China more and more, but yeah, but it is still, you know, the whole shuochang kind of style, the whole rapping vibe, like you're starting to see more, I guess you would say more like hip hop influence and things like that. Which I personally think is really, really cool. I'm a big fan of it. I think she's really awesome looking. I think her music is really great too. Her aesthetic, like her music videos, she's really, really good. I can maybe put a link in the comments for you guys later. I think she's really awesome and just sort of like, yeah, I don't know. Her lyrics are really good too. And as you guys know, I'm a big lyric person.
What's her Chinese name?
It's Liu Baixin. Liu Baixin.
Okay, Liu Baixin.
Would you say she's like a Chinese Billie Eilish? Because that's just the vibe I got.
Oh, that's actually not, that's not a terrible comparison. I think Billie Eilish is still probably a little bit more out there. I think she's still a little bit more eccentric than Liu Baixin is. Mm. But I would say sort of somewhere along that spectrum, yeah. Mm. Which I really like. I feel like in China, I haven't seen that vibe a lot yet. I mean, I think it's coming, but it is sort of still new. So I think it's really cool to sort of see that influence in China where it wasn't previously. You know what I mean? Mm. So that's Lexi. I think her music is really great. I think her lyrics are really great. And the last one I'm going to do, actually, I'm putting her on this list just because I think she's a really, really good singer. I don't really think she has her own albums or anything, but she was on that really famous show in China, the Zhongguo Haosheng'in. Yeah, so that's a good China voice, basically, is what it means. And I think she's phenomenal. I'll share my screen with you guys. Her name is, where did I put it? Because I have her Chinese name and her English name here. One second. Oh, yeah, Zhang Bichun.
That's who I was thinking of.
Yeah, she's incredible. Oh, sorry, I didn't mean to. I clicked on a comment. What style? I guess I should answer it now. Which one? Zhang Bichun. Her style, I think, is just more sort of normal pop music. But yeah, let me show you guys. So the thing about her is I just think she's got like a phenomenal voice. That's really what it is. I think her voice is really, really good. So this is her. She's, you know, she's cute. She's a cute girl. And I think she, you know, she's cute. And I don't really know much about her. And I don't really know much about any of these singers because, you know, as you guys know, I'm not a super duper fangirl. But I do think her voice is really beautiful just in general. And I really like going on YouTube and like listening to her sing. So she mostly does covers. She did a really good, I think she did the version of, she did a whole new world, Chinese mm-hmm. version. Wow, for the new Aladdin movie, which I didn't see. I assume it was bad.
It's good.
Where is that? Wait, guys, where is Jen? Why don't I see her?
She just went to the restroom.
Oh, she did. Okay.
Yeah, she'll be right back. And but I think anyway, do we want to answer different comments?
Yeah, let's do it. So yeah, so those are my three. So yeah, sorry guys. I'm not as big of a fangirl, unfortunately, but that's my petty, you know, I mean that's my contribution.
The thing is, I'm the same. Like I would say I'm a Gem fangirl. Like if I'm gonna say I'm a fangirl for somebody, it would be Gem. But I'm like you in the sense that I don't know all the details about their life and years and dates and blah 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 blah. Like it's just the music for me.
Yeah, exactly. Same for me. And you know, there aren't even like really like singers where I just like all of their songs. Generally, that's not the case. It's just I sort of
what
songs I like from various singers. You know.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I'm more of that type of person, but yeah.
Totally. Oh, yes. Oh, my goodness. But thank you for introducing, like, such interesting, like, singers as well. Like, it's been so wonderful to see just how, like, diverse everyone's different tastes are.
Yeah.
And, like, just the different kinds of music that we like. And I'm also really excited to see also, like, I think we have a little game that we're doing here pretty soon. Yes. We've got a lot of different... We're going to even learn more about each other.
Yay! Should we do this game right now? Oh my goodness, we should do it right now.
Let's do it right now.
Let's do it right now.
So,
I'm ready.
Okay, great. He's got the whiteboard. I'm just going to use my screen.
I'm going to probably use my screen too.
I'm going to
use my writing is going to be so bad.
Oh, well, I have this. I can just, I actually got markers. I bought markers, you guys, for the occasion.
Nice.
Oh my gosh, I love this. Okay, yes. Okay. Okay, so I guess we should explain what this game is. Okay, guys, so what we're going to be doing is we are going to have some kind of topic, and it's going to show up, like, right on the bottom here. And we are going to basically answer that with our favorite whatever. Each of us are going to answer, but we all are going to have different answers. For example, like, what is your favorite this person's song? Those kind of questions.
No.
So I think maybe we should just do, like, five, because we don't want to take up too much time with this game.
Mm.
But... let's see. Okay. I feel like, ooh. Okay. I have them lined up on my screen here. So let's just, ooh. Oh, okay.
I'm nervous.
I got it. Chinese song. Goosebumps.
Oh, I have it.
Okay. And to anybody watching, if you guys have a question like that you want us to answer like this, just type it up in the comments and maybe we'll answer yours as well. Okay, so I'm going to try to pop mine up on my screen.
Okay, well, I'm going to go ahead and do that too.
Okay. Ooh, I'm like so...
Oh, I actually do.
I'm so excited about this right now.
Okay.
Because there is like, I'm going to answer with the song that I was telling you about before.
Oh,
my God, I'm so excited.
Oh, that was too big. My answer was too big, you guys.
It's playing audio.
Uh-oh, you gave it away.
It was one note, I think.
No, that's okay. I'm kidding. Yeah, you're good.
Heart's thumping. Oh, my gosh. This is, like, my favorite song ever. I've watched this song. Can I just give my answer? Is everybody done?
Yeah, you know what? You go okay. Crazy. We're ready.
I'm ready.
I got mine on the screen as well.
Okay, okay. Okay. I need to okay, I'm gonna display it.
Yes! I'll tell you, okay.
If you guys have not seen this video, you need to watch it ASAP. Like,
Yeah, send it to me, please.
I want to hear it.
Oh, dude, but we'll be able to see that. We'll be able to see this, like the replay of this afterwards, anyway. So,
yes. True. But I did send it to the chats, so hopefully you guys can see it. Anyway, he does this little section in here where I can't really describe what he does, but he starts like doing this weird scream.
Yes, I know what you're talking about. Oh yeah, I've seen this. Okay,
y'all, like it is good. Anyway. Yeah, so, okay, you can even see he's going a little crazy, right? But it's all a performance. Oh, man, mad respect. I get chills like 7 times throughout this song. Anyway, that's my answer. Happy?
Love it.
Okay, so mine.
Oh, it's in the group chat.
Oh, I see.
Okay, so mine.
Okay, I'll do that.
Is Teng Hui Xian. It's a Cantonese song.
Whoa.
I don't think you can see my face. One sec. But yeah, so. This is a Cantonese song that I really like. And so Teng Hui Xian, like her most famous like song is like and like it's another Cantonese song. My Cantonese is so bad though. Like when I try to sing this, it just doesn't come out really well. Like like it's just so bad, but it's that's like such an amazing song. She also does this like kind of like this that just like has this amazing piano that just goes no 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 no, and it's just like and the 80s feel to it is just so powerful. So yeah, that's my favorite part.
I do like that synth. I like that synth.
I love it. Oh my gosh. Okay, who's next? Let's go, Laureate.
Sure thing. I hope you see
this. Can I do like one person?
Whoa.
Yeah, you can do one person.
How can I choose which person?
That's so big. Hi.
Just click on AJ.
You guys. Okay, thanks. Wait, what is it? Light Years Away. Oh, okay.
Light Years Away by Jem. But I talked about that one before, so I thought I'd also include Jinxi Nanyo by Marcus. His newest single is the songwriting is so good. And he's just singing some really, really unique stuff, like some really unique melodies that you'd hear in like a Disney soundtrack. And I just love that so much. So shouting out Marcus. But Light Years Away, first time I heard that song, it was like the goosebumps were insane and I still get them.
I feel the same way for that song because that was actually one of the first Chinese songs I ever listened to. And like the chills were unreal. Oh,
I love getting chills while listening to music.
Yes. You really feel something. Oh my gosh.
Yes.
Okay. Yes. DJ, you're up.
I'm up. Okay. So let me see. I want to share my screen for this too. Well, actually, I don't really need to. I wrote it, but it looks really bad. Oh, that's embarrassing.
Oh my gosh. Stop. It's so nice.
It is. No, I really do write like a 5-year-old because it's one of those things where like when I was in school at a certain point, like a year in, they made us type everything. So I can write, but it's like, you know what I mean? It's just not great. So I'm just going to share my screen quickly so you guys can see. Let me see. Sorry, guys. Okay, so this song gives me goosebumps every time. It's Liang Jing Ru. It's Hui Hu Xi De Tong. This song, I don't know. It's a bit of an older song as well. But every time I hear it, so again, it's one of those, it's a situation where the music in and of itself isn't necessarily, it's not that touching really, as far as I'm concerned, but I think the lyrics are really, really good. Sorry, this is going kind of slow, so it doesn't really matter. I'm going to stop sharing the screen.
Sing a little bit.
Oh, okay. I can sing a little bit of it. Let me see. I should probably just start from the, okay. 想念是会呼吸的痛，它活在我身上所有角落，哼你爱的歌会痛，看你的心会痛，连沉默也痛。遗憾是会呼吸的痛，它留在血液中来回哎呀滚动，后悔不贴心会痛，恨不懂你会痛，想见不能见最痛。
哇
So nice.
The lyrics are just so sad. So I really, my thing is really sad love song lyrics. And China,
yes,
got a ton of.
Oh my god!
You want a really sad love song? Like, China's got a plethora of them. So.
Yes, so true. Do you like Zhang Xinjie?
Oh my god! They're like. Their breakup songs make they put all to shame. They really do. So.
Oh my god!
Yes, I know they're so good. They're so good. When I first heard that song, I actually didn't understand it, and then I listened to it like a year later, and I understood the whole thing, and it was so beautiful, and I did cry. So. You know, I really love that song. I'm not a huge Liang Jinru fan, to be honest. I think she's good, but I'm not a huge, huge fan. But yeah, I really, really love that song. Oh, the other one I love is 可惜不是你陪我到最后. Have you guys heard that one?
It's
yes.
Love it.
So beautiful. Yeah. So yeah, that's my answer.
I love that. I love how much like passion you have for these. Makes me feel like my heart is warm listening to you.
Yes.
I love it.
Oh, good. Oh, good. I'm so glad.
Okay, let's think of what is our next question here. Also, if you guys have a topic that you want us to answer, just let us know in the comments, okay? Maybe I missed it, or I don't know, but let's move on to the next one. Okay, how about this? A Chinese song that cheers you up.
Oh!
I'm
going to say my answer.
Oh my god.
Okay, are we ready?
I'm so excited right now. Just to.
I'm so excited. This is going to be amazing. Like so bad and so good at the same time.
Oh. Ooh. Okay. I've got one.
Okay. I've got one too.
Okay, go. We want to hear it.
Okay. I'm gonna share my screen.
Okay. Go ahead, girl. Go ahead.
I'm just gonna turn that off for a second. Okay. Do you guys see it?
Yes.
Uh huh.
You heard it.
I don't think I've heard it. Can we hear a little bit of it? I don't know.
Sing it.
I don't know like the words. Like I just know like the beat is just like it's just like it's like.
Can we hear it for a second? Can we hear it?
You know what? Maybe we can make that happen. I don't know how to like add. Oh wait.
Oh no! If you can't add the music, like don't trouble yourself over it.
Okay, but just like. Can you hear it?
Oh, smile. Yeah. Oh girl, we can hear it.
Let me see.
Oh my god. I like it.
Okay. Hopefully copyright doesn't get me, but you know, they're
yeah, that should be seconds. Like if it's like a really short, then it should be fine, yeah.
Should be good. But anyway, that's my song. It really just it puts me in a mood, and I'm just really in the morning. Just play that, and you're in a good mood for the rest of the day, 100%.
Yeah, I'm in the mood already.
I feel it. I feel the good mood in my veins, flowing through my veins.
I love it. Okay, should we just go in the same order? Okay.
Okay. So, are we ready for mine?
Yes.
Okay. So this is Guo Fucheng, who's like. It's like 80s, like
oh my gosh! Oh, I'm gonna do one of his too.
And then this is
Para Para Sakura, so
it's like a Hong Kong singer singing about Japanese, and it's the best thing in the entire world.
Oh, yes.
Kawaii Sakura, ayo, come and dance. It's so good. I love this. But then it's like in Cantonese, and then it also has Mandarin, and then it also has Japanese. And it literally goes, Nandesuka.
Sakura.
Like, it's the best thing.
I love that. Just like the three most stereotypical Japanese words.
I know.
Do you understand everything?
Just like,
it's really easy. The Japanese is really, really simple. It's sakura. It's
the Cantonese, exactly. Though?
Who knows that?
Huh?
The Cantonese, you understand it?
The Cantonese, like, I don't understand it. Like, I can read the lyrics, but, like, my Cantonese is horrible. Like, I really need to work on Cantonese. That's all I can
say. I mean, that sounds good to me. I don't really know because I don't speak Cantonese either. It is an old song, yes. It's an old song. But I'm a big fan as well, actually. I really am a big fan.
I love you so much. Oh my god. You
I really like Wolf Wuchang. Okay.
Yes,
I really do.
Okay, what's up? Am I next or someone
You're next, boy.
You're next.
Okay. Yo, okay, so Marcus, if you see this, I'm sorry that I seem like such a Marcus fangirl, but my confession.
My confession, yay!
I think it's really cute how much you're fangirling over him. That's adorable.
Yeah, I'm just fangirling over my friend.
That's cute. I think that's sweet.
But I'm so happy to support him. Like, friends support each other. Like, he supports me. And
exactly,
like,
exactly.
And I'm I'm genuinely, like, I love this song so much. Right.
He's so good.
You should all check it out if you don't know it. My Confession by Marcus Lee. Would he put Li Junwei like in on YouTube? I don't even know what his name is on YouTube. I should know this.
Li Junwei. Yeah. So I'll go ahead and put his thing in the chat.
Yeah, do it.
In the chat for this. I'll put it on JJ's. Da-da-da.
Amazing. Yeah, I love Marcus's songs. I was actually listening to that song the other day on repeat like 5 times because I was like, this is such a bop. So,
it's such a bop. It's such a bop.
And the video is just too cute.
Yeah.
Okay, well, JJ.
Okay, me. Okay, so I think I've got this screen showing thing down as well. So I actually now, I was so inspired. So now I also want to do a Guo Fu Cheng song as well.
Yay!
He is cute. Like I did, that was another one like a few years ago I had a really big crush on because he's like so cute. Well, like at least like in like 1980.
Yes.
Yeah. I mean, actually he still looks good to be honest. Guys, if you know who Guo Fu Cheng is, I think his English name is Aaron Kwok, right?
Aaron Kwok, yeah.
Actually, he aged well.
He aged very well.
There you go.
He aged really well. So anyway, I think my friend Ming was watching. So if he's watching, he knows that this is the song we like to sing karaoke together. So let me share my screen with you quickly. Let me see you guys. Sorry, this like takes me so long still.
You got it, girl.
Let's see. Where is it? Okay, there we go. Here we go. So I really like this song. Can you guys see?
Yeah.
Oh, look at it. Look at this 80s-ness. Can you guys hear it?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, it's going so slow. I don't know why it's going so slow. Dwayne Ibuwan, okay? Just look at this. I mean, you guys, it's going to be, it's going so slow. Oh, look at that.
This song, I love it.
Oh, it's so good.
Ooh. Yes.
Okay. Oh, JJ, look at you go.
I know, really. This song makes me so happy, you guys. Okay, that's enough. Anyway.
I want to dance like that.
That's my top choice. I'm a huge fan.
It's such a good song.
It's such a good song. And he's like so cute and like into it. Yeah, someone wrote. Yes. Someone wrote. Dwayne
I-I-I-Buan.
Oh my gosh. Yeah, which guys, for those of you that don't know, that means like my love for you is like never ending. It's like really cute. So yeah, so that song, that's definitely like one of my favorite songs and always makes me really, really happy.
Yes. Good choice.
Oh, am I still sharing my screen?
No, it's not good.
Okay, all sorry guys. I'm really sorry for these technical issues, everyone. I don't know what I'm doing.
Okay, let's see. Okay. Does anybody have an idea for a last little topic that maybe we can do here? I'm looking through the comments and I mean, you guys are loving the songs that we're talking about, so that's what makes me really happy.
You know, somebody wanted us to sing Hongdo, actually. You guys know Hongdo?
Oh, that's yes. Hongdo. Yes. Yes. Yes.
I don't know the names.
Oh, yeah. You played it?
Yes.
Oh, wow. That was a really good introduction, actually.
It's the intro. You can sing it.
Okay, so
or you can sing part of it.
So the thing
is, Wang Fei song.
It's a Wang Fei song. Yeah. Does everybody want to get lyrics up, maybe? Because I don't think we should sing it all together. Because if we sing it all together, there's going to be a lag.
It's going to suck.
So we would sing like 一句一句.
Yeah, 一句一句, or like maybe like 一段一段.
Like 一段. Okay.
对，我觉得可能一段一段来唱应该比较好一些.
Yeah.
How about y'all? Because I don't think I'm knowing this song.
Oh, that's okay. Okay. We'll just do a little bit of it. Okay, so I'll start. Are you guys ready?
I'm so ready.
Okay.
还没好好的感受雪花绽放的气候，我们一起颤抖，会更明白什么是温柔。 还没跟你牵着手，走过荒芜的沙丘，可能重拾以后学会珍惜前尘和地久。有时候，有时候，OK，我会相信一切有尽头。
想距离开都有时候，没有什么永恒不朽。可是我有时候宁愿留恋，宁愿选择留恋不放手。 Then what has to go? That's too high, right?
Someone else can sing that. We were all singing in the wrong key. This should be easier. If we keep going, but we don't have to keep going.
I'm nervous, okay? I'm nervous.
No, it's just the key wasn't established. We didn't establish the key before we started singing. Like, I would have had to play it on piano.
You're right. I'm sorry, everybody.
Which I did, by the way, I guess we forgot.
I'm nervous.
What's the song that you want to sing?
Putting me on the spot, girl.
Sing something for us, girl. Sing something for us.
Oh, yo.
Wait, what about maybe using one of your like game questions to figure out a song that we all know? Okay. Or one of the questions in the comments or something. What's a Hua Chenyu song that you can sing?
None of them.
Yeah.
See, put me on the spot. Like, I'm just like, I don't know. I can't even think. You know what I mean?
You got it. I know exactly. I'm exactly the same. I don't do well.
Okay, I have a nervous.
Oh my God.
I have a proposition. I don't know what, or like, I don't know if you guys will know this song. Okay, let me.
It doesn't matter if we know it.
Do it, girl.
No, we just want to hear your beautiful voice.
Okay, I'm going to do it. Okay, so this is what it's called. I'm putting it up here just so people can see. So this is, I got this from one of our questions, like our banner questions, because it's like, one of the questions was going to be, what's your favorite underground or not well-known Chinese artist? And so this is her. Okay, I love Karen Cici. She is, I think actually she's from Taiwan, I think, but she grew up in the U.S. But she sings in like Chinese and English, and I love it. But I have to wait. This is one of the songs I also studied. Do you like my notebook?
Oh my gosh, is that Good Karma?
That is Love Me Some Good Karma.
Good Karma is my favorite.
Right?
Yay. Oh my God, it's so relatable. Literally me all the time.
Okay, let me see.
It's me all the time.
Okay, so this song is lovely, like, and it's just such a cute song. So it's called FaceTime because it's about like you have to, like, it's I don't know, it's like their relationship is over the phone or whatever. Okay, anyway, cute.
Oh, how modern.
Yeah, truly. Okay. Oh. So I don't know how to play it on guitar, so I'm just going to sing it, okay? Mm-hmm. Oh, I'm nervous. Okay.
You got it, girl. Please. I know I didn't even sing the right key, so you don't have to worry.
I'm not going to as well. Okay.
Baby, what you wish will need you find the name. The money can do your thing. Down, down, up. Me sure what the fashion the man I'm a demand. Now lean in on the shank way.
Yeah, that's kind of how it goes. I sang so I'm not going to do the chorus because then it'd be way too high. So I swear off wrong. That's fine.
Okay, no apology. You don't have to apologize. That was beautiful.
Yeah.
That was so pretty.
And JJ, you don't have to apologize for your handwriting.
Hey.
No, but I do though. Because that was tragic. But thank you.
Oh my goodness.
That was great, Jen.
That was great.
Thank you. Thank you for like, okay, you guys are too sweet. You seriously are too sweet. Okay, so if we want to, I guess we already sang songs. We played our game.
Oh,
so
yeah.
That's kind of it. And we've gone like an hour and a half in. So I guess that's kind of everything we wanted to cover. But I think what would be very good right now is guys, plug your information in, plug your channels, plug your Instas, do your thing, just plug everything.
Like we type it in or we just one at a time start?
You can just say it.
Sorry. I don't know. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm just like randomly clicking on things because this is my second live stream. Okay, you've got it.
Yeah, Loria, go for it. Where can people find you if they
want? Follow me on MayPie. Just kidding. My MayPie's dead, but.
Oh my God. He's so old. That's such a niche joke.
We're so old.
Happy and I were getting nostalgic about MayPie last night. We were watching her old MayPie videos. Like, yo, this was an era. Like, it's because of MayPie that we know each other.
Yes,
it's because of MayPie that like we're all here talking.
Wow. Yes.
Wow. I don't even know what MayPie is, but thank you, MayPie. Thank you.
Yo, yeah, exactly. Yo, you can go check out our MayPie. You can go check out Happy's MayPie. She was a punk back then.
Happy was punk look.
Oh, wow. No, that was when, I don't know, when I was in China, I was much more fashionable. But yes, MayPie.
That was, basically Douyin destroyed that, right? Is that
Douyin.
Was that Douyin basically came and MayPie became a thing of the past, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's too bad.
You're like, yeah, that's
so I love followers.
MayPie was just like my thing. Mm. But I'm okay with the change. It's fine. It just, you know. Happen in good time.
Judah.
Yeah, I understand. I never did the MayPie thing somehow. Mm-hmm. Somehow, surprisingly, I didn't do the MayPie thing. It seems like I would have, but.
You just started on YouTube?
No, so actually, I started on Bilibili first. So I started on
YouTube
first.
Oh,
yeah. Okay.
Sorry, all your videos on YouTube, they're also on Bilibili?
Yeah, they are, except it was really an interesting thing. When I first started my channel, I was doing much better on Bilibili, and YouTube wasn't taking off at all.
That makes sense.
But then recently it's been really weird because it's sort of been the opposite. I've been getting a lot more attention on YouTube. Yeah, you've noticed that too?
Yo, I'm just going to say that
everyone has.
Quarantine made people want to get proactive and learn a language. And I think that might have to do with your views going up. I just had this realization right now. Did you think about that already?
I have thought about that. Yeah. I think that was really helpful. Well, so originally, all of my content was just, it was literally all in Chinese and wouldn't even have English subtitles. So I was hoping to get the Chinese speaking audience on YouTube, but they weren't really finding it. And so then when I sort of made it a little more English speaking focused and started putting English subtitles on as well, then things started to grow a lot more.
Yeah, it happens.
Yes, I am on TikTok. Someone said yes, I am on TikTok. Okay, I'm just answering these comments.
Yeah, and then
TikTok,
Jen, you're also
or Douyin or both?
Really big on that too.
I'm on. See, that's okay. So I have TikTok and Douyin, but again,
yeah, they're different. It's
a weird thing because TikTok is doing better than Douyin, which you wouldn't think. You would think Douyin would do better, but it's not.
The algorithms are totally different. So
yeah,
I
exactly.
actually, I had a few videos that went viral on Douyin, so I don't even have TikTok. So I'm only on Douyin.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
The original.
So yeah,
Yeah, the original, the OG. So for me, it's the opposite. They do well on TikTok, but not really so much on Douyin, but I think it's an algorithm thing. I just haven't been using the right hashtags and they haven't been getting into the algorithm really.
But JJ, do you make content that's specifically for TikTok or do you just post snippets of your YouTube stuff?
So right now what I'm doing is I'm just posting snippets of my YouTube stuff. I was thinking of taking it more seriously and starting to do videos specifically for TikTok. But at this point, it's kind of uncertain what the future of TikTok in America is. Basically. Right. Yeah. Happy knows. Right. Because we're not sure what that whole situation is with Microsoft and everything else.
Yeah.
So I'm kind of waiting to see what happens with that before I start taking that super seriously.
Got it.
I'm just going to go ahead and say that YouTube is like a good place to put your focus in.
Oh, yeah. I completely agree.
You can trust it to be legit. Like the thing about MayPie is that you felt like, dude, I'm huge. I'm so big. But it's like so many of our fans, no offense, were like fake, you know, like you.
Oh, really?
They sent us bots, and those fake fans made more real people get introduced to us. So like more people started following us and caring about us. And we got real comments. You do live streams and people are commenting and it's like, you know, there's real people there, but it's kind of just like YouTube, I will trust to be kind of a really good place to build your brand where like you can sort of establish longevity where people, it's not just like a 2 second short attention span, like TikTok video, like people who watch YouTube care about what you're doing. Like your videos are like 8 minutes long and people are going to sit there because they care. And if they follow you, it's like, they're going to care about you for a lot longer than someone they found on TikTok for like a 5 second video.
Well, you know, that's actually such an interesting point because on TikTok, I see this. Well, on TikTok and Douyin, you see this all the time. People will have millions of followers, but then you get a video and it'll only have like 5,000 views. And you're like, that doesn't make sense that they only have 5,000 views, you know, per, you know, for 2 million followers. And that's just because no one is actually invested so much in the content. They just see a video they like and they go subscribe and then they forget about you and never think about you ever again, right?
True. True, but YouTube can also be like that.
It can be. No, I completely agree.
It takes a lot of work. To do what you're doing takes a lot of work.
I'm also actually really like interested in like, because Jen, you do like Xigua TV as well, right?
Oh, I've been thinking of doing Xigua.
To me, it's my best platform for Chinese social media.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Why do I not even know what that is?
Oh, I don't know.
Because you're too old.
It's a similar thing. It's a short video sharing platform. I've been thinking of getting into it.
Yeah. So yeah, I post like the same stuff on Xigua as I do on Bilibili and stuff. But I like Xigua, like, and I like Bilibili, and I don't really use Douyin. I just watch people on Douyin. I don't put my own stuff on there. But yeah. But yeah, I love it. I highly recommend. Very nice. But I can tell you more about later my experiences working on both. But yeah. Okay. Anyway. Let's go into this. Like, Laurie, where can people find you on Instagram, YouTube?
Everything is at Laurie LaChance. We can just put that in the comments. And there's my name. Like, if you want to search it on YouTube, my stuff is there.
Perfect.
So, yeah, it's like kind of the same name. Oh, Chinese. Look, for Chinese social media, I'm going to write Laurie Ai and then Laurie. Can I write that? Hold on.
Not on this banner, but you can write it in the chat.
I can write in the chat like right here. Like, I just need to activate my Chinese keyboard. Hold on. Oh, yeah. And I got this, like, Google Chrome extension thing that, like, reads Chinese characters. Did you recommend that in one of your videos?
I did. Yeah, I recommended that in a video. I'm so glad someone downloaded it. That's amazing.
It's so good.
Oh, good. Yeah, that is. I use it all the time. It's amazing. You guys, it's this plugin that I think it's for Max, this plugin that, like, translates Chinese words for you real time. It's really amazing.
That's awesome. Yeah,
and what I didn't realize, like, you can have it on all the time, and like when you're reading English and stuff, like nothing happens. It's just, it's only gonna appear for when you need it. You don't have to like turn it on and turn it off, right?
Oh, sorry, I was reading something. No, you don't. You can just keep it on all the time, and it just is. It sits at the top of your screen, and it says on, and if you want to turn it off, it just But if it's on, there's like a little red button that constantly says on unless you click it, and then it will turn it off. It's amazing. It's amazing.
Cool.
Okay, great. Inside of the platform. That's amazing. Okay. Love that. So, who's next? Happy?
Happy.
Oh,
happy.
Woo. My my little plugins are the Asian Enthusiast. Da, 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 da,
da, da, da. Woo!
And then my Chinese is actually, which I put in your chat as well, is Luoying Jiang Jia Lao Wai. So Luo Ying is my Chinese name, and then Jia Laowai, which means like a foreigner, like impersonator kind of way to say.
Oh, that's yeah, that's cute. Jia Laowai, that's cute.
So my Instagram is the Asian Enthusiast with like the Asian Enthusiast happy, and then my YouTube as well, and then my Douyin and Meipai for the OGs, and also Weibo and Bijian. So Bilibili is all Luo Ying Jiang Jia Laowai. I still have to try. I want to call it like Suika TV, but it's like Xigua Shiping. I'm totally like, Jen, you've like inspired me to do that. So I'll totally have to try that.
I love that you just looked over to Jen's screen.
I know. I'm like how did you do that?
Wait, are we're all in the same position for all of us, right?
Like, oh, wait, is it like the Brady Bunch? Are we all like.
Yeah, so I've been doing that this entire time. I've been interacting with you guys.
I love that's
so funny. Story of a lovely lady.
And what about you, JJ?
Oh, me. How do I put my stuff here? Okay, so yeah, JJ says, if you type in JJ says on YouTube, you'll find me. And if you want to find me on Instagram, you can just type in JJ says official, which sounds like so lame to be like official, but I tried JJ says and it was taken. So I had to do JJ's
official version.
Official. Yeah, I know. It sounds like, ooh, I think I'm so important, but JJ was just taken. So I couldn't. But yeah, if you type in JJ says on YouTube, if you type in JJ says on Instagram, it should come up. On Bilibili, however, if you want to find me, it's probably better to type in my Chinese. So I'm just putting that in the comments here. That's 学脸说, if you want to find me on Bijan. 对，就是如果你要就是在B站上，如果你要查到我的话呢，你就可以查那个学联说，对，exactly. It's kind of. 其实我听说过这个名字比较老式. Some people have told me this name is like a little bit more old school, but like when my teacher helped me pick this name, I didn't speak any Chinese, so I was like, that sounds nice. Yeah, it's like apparently it's like Esther or Myrtle or something like that, but like.
I'm Chinese version.
Exactly. It's the Chinese version. So I'm used to it.
Isn't that the situation for most of us? Like we all picked our Chinese names when we didn't really know what we were doing.
Exactly. And so they can pick like the weirdest names.
And then we're and attached to them. Yeah. We're just like yours, used to them being our name.
Yeah, because JJ's like is, but then it's like a Chinese, which doesn't have to do with your English name. But then like Gloria and then also like Jinye like have more of like the sound.
Well, I think I think my teacher thought it did sound similar because, you know, well, see, my real name is Jillian, right? So my teacher thought Jillian and Xuelian, she thought they sounded kind of the same. She thought like, yeah, like, what are the troubles with that? Actually, for people that speak Chinese in the audience, 其实我第一个老师帮我取这个名字, the first name I was ever given was Bai Mu Dan, which I didn't know at the time. Apparently that's like the name of like a prostitute name. Oh. Yeah, I didn't know that because how was I supposed to know that? Like that's supposed to be like the old style, sort of like an old Chinese drama. Like the courtesans would have names like that.
Oh no.
And I didn't know that. So I was walking around telling people that my name was White Peony and everybody was like laughing and I didn't know why. It's like not a good name for normal people apparently.
Definitely. Oh my goodness. Well, thankfully you got a much better name.
Thankfully, yeah. I mean, Xuelian is apparently old school, but,
but hey,
it's not the name of a prostitute.
I like it. And then Jen, for those watching that don't know you,
what? Can you say that one more time? I didn't really hear you.
Cut out accounts.
Ah, okay. Well,
okay. So, and then for those who don't know Jen, go ahead, bro.
Thank you. Okay, so I guess you guys can just find me Jen, or you can find so many different things. Okay, so if you just search this, you'll find me probably on Instagram. You'll find me on Bilibili, Xinhua, Weibo, and YouTube. Yeah, or you can search That's Really Jen. You'll also find me search That's Really Jen. But, yeah. Hey. That's about it. I post videos just kind of like about culture. So hopefully you guys would enjoy that. Yep, that's basically it. So I guess that's everything for today. That's everything we had to cover. If you guys have any questions or anything, just leave them in the comments so that we can still answer them in the future, because that would be lovely. Mm-hmm. And hope you guys enjoyed and maybe learned something new. And thank you guys all so much for coming and joining in. And thank you to all of these lovely individuals who have joined us on the stream today.
And, I learned some stuff. I learned about some new songs.
I learned some stuff too. I'm excited to look up some of these artists and become a fangirl finally.
Totally. Me too.
Like send me those songs that give you goosebumps, please. Like in our own
group. Yeah.
Totally. I wanna go and listen to them for sure. Okay, well,
amazing. No, thank you so much, Jen, for putting this together. Like, this was such an amazing experience, and to talk with you guys, like, I appreciate this so much.
I love it. I haven't met any of you, and like, I feel like we have such a good connection.
I love it too, you guys, because honestly, like, this little niche of the internet is so small, right? And so it's really nice to find like-minded people and create this little friendship circle.
Thank you so much.
Someone says really enjoyed. Please have more. Guys, we have to do this again, clearly.
Yes.
We're going to do it again. 100.
We have more game questions too, ready to go.
We do. So we have more topics to talk about. If you guys want to see more, just let us know, okay? Sounds great. That's it for us today. So I guess we're signing off now. Thank you guys so much for watching. Hopefully we'll see you guys on the future live stream, yeah?
Let's do a beation before we go, everybody.
Beation.
Bye.